Hello everyone, I welcome you to my channel. Today I'm going to show you how to compress large video file using command line and without losing a single bit of quality. So let's begin. Now the software that I'll be using to compress a large video file will be this FFmpeg. So for that you need to go to your favorite browser and in here just simply type FFmpeg download, then enter, and then you'll be seeing this https://ffmpeg.org is basically our first search result. So now just simply click on this download FFmpeg. So this will automatically going to redirect you to this official site of FFmpeg. In here you need to just simply scroll down a bit this download link for Linux, Windows and Mac. So we are basically going to install this FFmpeg in your Windows 10 operating system. So in here just simply click on this Windows build from gan.dev. So you just simply click on that. And this will going to redirect you to this codex FFmpeg page. In here you need to just simply scroll down a bit. You need to scroll down till you get this git. So here this is the link that we are basically going to click. So this https://gan.dev/ffmpeg/builds/ffmpeg/git-full.7z. So we need to click on this link. So just simply click on that, and this will going to start downloading FFmpeg. I have already downloaded it, so just simply cancel it. And if I just simply minimize my browser, and if I just simply go to my download directory, our FFmpeg 2021-05-26 version has been rightly downloaded over here. We need to extract this. So for that you need to have at least one zip extractor software. In my channel I have already made a couple of videos, one about how to install 7z software and also how to install this winner. Currently I am using winner, so I'll be also putting those links in the description. So if you face any difficulty to extract this, then you need to just follow that link and you need to download that software and install it, and then again come back to this video. I have already downloaded winner, so it's very easy for me right now. So all you need to do is you need to just simply right click on it, and then you need to simply click on this extract to FFmpeg 2021 over here. Just simply click on that, and this will automatically going to extract this FFmpeg over this folder, and you can clearly see it has rightly extracted over here. So if you just go inside that directory, you can clearly see this FFmpeg has been rightly extracted over here. So what I'll be doing is just simply go a directory back, and I'm just going to rename it to a sorter form. So just simply delete all other things and just simply give only FFmpeg, and then you need to just simply right click on it, then copy, and then you need to go inside this C directory, then just simply right click on it and then paste, so that we basically going to move this FFmpeg over our C directory, and you can clearly see our FFmpeg folder has been rightly copied over here. So now just simply go inside that folder, then go inside that bin directory, and now you need to just simply click on this address bar, and then just simply right click on it and then copy, then just simply minimize it. And then if you just simply click on this search icon and then just simply type environment, you'll be seeing this edit the system environment variable. So you need to click on this edit system environment variable, and this will going to open the system properties. In here you need to click on this environment variables, and then you need to click on this path, then edit, and this will automatically going to open this edit environment variable window. So just simply click on new, and then just simply right click on it and paste that path, that is this c/ffmpeg/bin. So you have rightly copied that path. Just now just simply click on OK, then again OK, then again OK. And now if you just simply go to your command prompt, and in here just simply type FFmpeg dash version, then enter, you'll be seeing this prompt from your command prompt. So it's basically stating that FFmpeg version 2021-05-26 has been rightly installed on our machine. So now that you know your FFmpeg has been rightly installed, so you just simply go to our directory where this video is practically lying. So I have this video over here, and if I just go to this details section, you can clearly see the video size is 144 MB. And the video length is 1 minute 22 seconds. Now I'm going to show you how to compress this file into just a mere 15 to 16 MB file. I can promise you, you can also do the same for your videos as well. So after installing FFmpeg, you need to just simply go to this address bar and you need to just simply type cmd, then enter. And this will be automatically going to open this command line inside your Visac directory. So that is basically where our video is practically lying. In here you need to just simply copy and paste this syntax. I'll be putting this entire syntax in our description, so you can just simply copy it from there. All you need to do is you need to just simply edit this file name. So if you check this video, the file name is mvi_3158, right? And the file extension is mov video file. So mov is basically our file extension. So I have given this .mov and the name of our file mvi3158. In your case, you might see some other file name. So you need to just simply edit this file name only. So just simply copy that link from your description. I am just simply copying it from my notepad, and then just simply click on this top of this command prompt, then right click on it, then edit, and then paste. And this will going to paste this total command over here, and then just simply click on enter, and this will automatically going to start compressing your video file. Now let us first look at our syntax in the meantime. So this -c basically means codec using this libx library, and we are basically setting our bitrate of our video to 1.5 MB. So this -v basically means bitrate, and this -c basically means codec, and v for video, right? And similarly, we need to do the same codec for audio using AAC library. And then we are basically going to do the same for bitrate for audio, and we are basically setting this 128 KB for our bitrate for audio. And then this output.mp4 is basically our compressed file that going to be outputted. And now if I just simply go to again a command prompt, you can clearly see our process has been rightly completed. So if you just simply go to our directory, you can clearly see our output file has been rightly generated over here. And if you just go to this detail section of this video, you can clearly see our video size has been rightly compressed to only 16.5 MB. Now you might be saying that our video quality might have changed or might have degraded, right? I can promise you it hasn't degraded a bit. So let us first check. So let us first open it. And you can clearly see our video quality hasn't been degraded a bit, right? I can also prove you that by just simply opening this couple of videos in my side by side, and you can clearly see that our video hasn't been degraded a bit. So you can clearly see these two videos parallelly in two windows. So in this way, you compress a large video file into a smaller file. So you can clearly see I have this file of 144 MB, and I have rightly compressed it to 16.5 MB. So that's all for this video, friends. I have rightly shown you how to compress larger video file into a compressed video file and without losing any quality. So that's all for this video. I have this website called geekyscript.com. In here, you'll be seeing various tutorials along with some blogs that I have written. So do check out website geekyscript.com. Thank you very much for watching this video. If you like this video, then please give it a like and so do share with your friends. Thank you very much for watching this video and God bless you all.